Inside, Ninja. Come on inside. Settle down, Flappy. Longy. Dagdu. Are you ready for the story? Then you have to settle down. Alright. Ninja. What are you looking at? It's locked down. Stay inside. Okay, enough. It's so hot. Oh, I think our friends are here. Are you shy? I think somebody is shy. Say hello. Good job. Hello everyone and welcome to Katha by Shraddha. We have many friends here, but let me introduce you first to Ninja Hathi. Say hello, Ninja. Hello. And we have here with his really long, where do you go? Here we are, long trunk. This is Mr. Longy. He loves to sleep. You see his eyelids are closed. See them? He sleeps through every story I tell him. This here is Dagdu, and he is going to help me with my story today. And the grand master of them all is Mr. Flappy. Hello, Flappy. Say hello. Oh, he's a big load to pick up. Oh, he's big, isn't he? Say hi to Flappy. Alright. So today, I'm going to put Ninja Hathi here. And I'm going to set Flappy back down comfortably. Are you ready to listen to a story? Yes? Alright. Alright, Dagdu. Alright, Longy. So the story today is a very old folk tale by the Kadar community in South India. Do you know what a folk tale means? A folk tale is a story that has been told over many generations verbally. So it's usually not written down somewhere, but the elders of the community sit with the next generation and tell them a story. So that's called a folk tale, when a story has been handed down from generation to generation to generation. So today's story is from the Kadar community and told over many generations about how the elephants became friends with the Kadars. The Kadar community is a small Adivasi community. The Kadar community lives along the border of Kerala and Tamil Nadu in the Anamalai and Paramvikulam hills. Kadar, the word itself, means forest dwellers. So this is a community that lives in the forest and off of the forest. They live in beautiful harmony with the forest, not taking more than they need and always giving back to the forest and taking care of the forest and the animals within it. So, the Kadar community actually believes in a very powerful entity called Kadavul. They believe that Kadavul is the creator of all humans, animals, plants, the whole world. So, at the beginning of the story, Kadavul, after creating all of humankind and animalkind, got a bit concerned and was wondering how were the humans faring, the people that he made for the forests. And Kadavul came to the Kadars and asked them, "How are you doing? Are you doing well? How do you survive with all these wild beings around you in the forest?" And he was especially concerned about how they were doing with the elephants. Why? Because elephants are these beautiful, magnificent, huge animals. And he was wondering how the humans were living in peace with elephants. And the Kadar storytellers, the Kadar elders, told Kadavul, "Well, it's a very long story. Would you like to hear it?" He said, "Yes, let's be seated. Let's tell you our story of how the Kadars and the elephants became friends. Would you like to listen to it too?" Okay. So a long time ago, in the Kadar community, there lived a very young boy. He was a very smart and resourceful young lad. Resourceful means he used to find solutions to problems from all the resources that he saw around him. He used to go every day into the forest with his mother and father when they went into the forest to hunt, to gather food, and to get shelter, to get firewood and get other things for their shelter. And he used to observe a lot around him. He used to listen to the forest as he went with his parents deep into the forest. He used to look at the trees. He used to memorize the pathways in the jungle. And he started learning like this by going with his parents into the forest and coming back home. And one day when he was old enough to live by himself, he decided, you know what? I really love the forest. I love its smells. I love its sounds. I love the feel of the forest. Sounds. What do you think a forest sounds like? Should we make some forest sounds? Yes. The trees are swishing. Oh, oh, oh. The birds. And maybe the let's see. Maybe you can hear some soft trumpets in the distance. Boom, boom, boom. Shh, shh, shh. Can you make some forest sounds? Very good. All right. So he decided to build a tree house in the biggest tree that he could find deep in the forest. A tree house is a special name. It's called Madam. So he went into the forest and chose a big, strong and wide tree and built his tree house over there. And slowly over the days, he became friends with the animals and started living in peace with all of them. He used to eat the fruits and the roots that he found in the forest, and he was a very happy young man. But there was one thing that he wished. He really wished that he could be. He wished he was friends with the majestic, grand elephants. They were so big and huge that he wouldn't dare make friends with them, and they were really wild. One day, when this young man was sitting in his treehouse, he heard the trumpeting of elephants and a herd passing close by to his treehouse. Let's see. Woo! And he came out of his treehouse near the door to watch them. And that's when he noticed that there was one elephant. Daguru is going to help us show you this part of the story. There was one elephant that was limping along and not going as fast as the herd. And the herd was moving ahead and she was just slow, and he wondered why. And then he noticed that this poor little elephant couldn't walk well because she had a splinter in her foot. And she kept trying to shake it off, and she kept trying to shake it off, but it wouldn't come out of her foot. And so she limped along and limped along. And finally, she got so tired that she decided to have a little bit of a rest. So she turned around and came right under the young man's tree and settled down for a rest. The young man felt very sad. He really felt her pain, and he could see that she was in a lot of pain. So he quietly, without making a sound, climbed down from his treehouse and checked to see, has the herd gone? Had the herd gone? And yes, the herd had moved on ahead, leaving her behind, pretty sure that she would catch up with them. And as she turned away to look at the herd, he quickly came around the elephant, and with a lot of effort, he pulled that splinter out. And immediately she turned and she was about to run over him. But he held his ground. I think if it was me, I would have run away. But this young man was very brave and he knew that he had helped this elephant. So he stood his ground and he looked at the elephant in her eyes. And she was getting ready to run over him. When she came charging. Suddenly, she realized that the pain in her leg was less and was becoming lesser and lesser by the minute. And she stopped. And she thought, elephants are very intelligent creatures. And she realized that this young man had something to do with removing the pain from her leg. So she gave him one last look. And then she started going after her herd. And she left him. So that young man said, wow, that was quite an experience. And he went on living his life. Some days after that, he was again in his treehouse when he heard a single elephant coming by. And he came out of his treehouse to see. And he saw this lone elephant coming near his treehouse. And he got very worried actually because, you know, a single elephant that has been separated from his or her herd can be quite dangerous. But then he recognized his friend that he had helped before. And just as he was watching, she came near the treehouse and she raised her trunk and she picked him up out of the treehouse and put him on her back. He loved it. And he was so happy. And then she took him deep into the forest. And she helped gather a lot of fruits and dug for many roots. And soon she had made a huge pile for him, filled with fruits and roots. It was almost like she was saying thank you. And that she was doing him a good deed in return. So the young man was very happy. But he said, my dear friend, I cannot eat all of this huge mountain of fruits and roots that you have gathered for me in one go, and they will go bad after some time. Do you know what I would really like to do? I would really love to plant some seeds that can grow into grain and that I can store in my storehouse and then eat all year long. Can you help me with that? After the elephant had listened to him, without any further ado, she turned away and she went away. And our dear young man, he was very surprised, but he decided, well, I think she understood what I said, so I'm going to wait. So he waited patiently. And not for long, though, he didn't wait for too long, because soon he heard the whole herd coming back with her. Thump, 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 thump. Trumpeting loudly, and they reached the space that he was in, and very soon they had pulled down some trees and cleared some shrubs and cleared a big clearing inside that forest. A small clearing was made for him. The young man was so thrilled and he said, thank you so much. And then the herd left. The young man, smart as he was, what did he do? He gathered all of that foliage, all the leaves and broken branches and the shrubs and the bushes, and made a big pile in the center and built a protective fence around it. And then put that mountain of foliage on fire. He wanted to burn all those leaves down. And do you know why he put a protective fence around his fire? Because he did not want the rest of the forest to catch fire. After the flames had died down, he checked and the earth was still hot. So he waited until it had cooled down, and then he sprinkled some seeds over there. And then after many months, because he knew that the rains were coming, and then after the rains, the seeds would grow and become into plants of grain. So after many months, when the seeds had grown into plants and the grain was ready to harvest, he went again to his clearing. And do you know what he found there? He found the herd of elephants waiting for him. And they were waiting to see if he was happy with his harvest. And he was so happy with his bountiful harvest that he decided that I am going to collect only what I need. And the rest I will leave for the forest and the elephants. So he harvested as much grain as he needed, and he left the stalks and some grain for the elephants to enjoy. And they did, and they ate to their fill, and then they left. And he told them very softly that this is how we all survive together, in peace and in harmony. And that's the story why to this day that the elephants and the carders are very good friends. All because of the good deed of one young man many years ago. So this wonderful story was told to the authors of this book. Oh, ninja, you fell down. Here we go. Sit here. Of this book. It's called Speaking to an Elephant. And it's written by Manish Chandi and Madhuri Ramesh, with beautiful illustrations by Matthew Frey. And these stories that are in here were told to these authors firsthand by Carder elders. I hope you like the story. And is it time to say bye now? Yeah? Let's see if Ninja is ready to say bye. Say bye to Tagru. Bye. And to Longi. Longi is still asleep. Let's see if I can help him wake up. Longi, did you not like the story? Bye, Flappy. Say bye. Bye. And bye.